YouTube! I am Penstar, and this is Hearthlands Strategy and Tactics Episode 4. So in our last episode, we built up our second housing block up to level 5, just like the original. We are sitting at just a hair over 1,000 people, with extra room for another 116, which is not too shabby. We are ready to continue growing, both economically and population-wise, and also militarily. So one of the things that we can kind of get ourselves into... We got a lot of thirsty people here. A lot of thirsty people. We can be making a lot more wine and selling it for hefty profits. But the other thing is we need to get into clothing to get our houses up another notch. So it is time to start expanding our economy. Now, the time of year is actually quite nice for both the plant expansions. Cotton is planted from July to October, so just right around the corner. And our lovely alcohol is planted June to August. It is May, so we can get both of these in the ground very soon. And we've got enough workers to make it happen for us. All right, so I'm going to actually want to double our wine production here. So, winery. Like so. Extend out the road. Winery. This time doing it correctly. Extend out the road like so. Now we also want to get our cotton farms. Now you don't, the scarecrow's only for grain and turnip plots. So the cotton plots can be put out wherever and you don't need to be worried about crows. That being said, we do want to be mindful of that. Let's put our, one other thing is, we're eventually going to need to grow our own grain. We can only import it for so long. But we're going to want to make sure that our grain farms and our cotton farms are very far away from each other. The reason for that is that the farmers can screw up each other's schedules if they try and help each other's plots. The intent behind that is all well and good, but we don't want them to screw that up. So we're going to make sort of a little a new road nub here. And let's make ourselves a couple of cotton farms up here. Again, 24 plots. Doesn't have to be right next to it, but nearby is ideal. So there's 12 right there. One, two, three, four, five. 6, 7. It's okay if you go a little bit over. That should be fine. And then over here, we'll just throw down another batch of them. Good enough. Probably a few too many plots there, but eh. They'll make do with what they got. So that will be all we need for the moment. The other thing we want to get into here is a more diverse military. Now, if I remember correctly, somebody was selling us, wanted to sell us stone. Yeah, Dunley wants to sell us stone. We want to buy stone. In fact, we're going to need another storage yard just for stone. That can go off over here. Make you only for stone. We can also start harvesting our own stone, but we need a supply of wood to be able to build the quarry and also the tech. So we'll just import the stone. And then once we reach 16, which will take us a year, we can build our next planned expansion. And Dunley will continue to like us wonderfully. Now, the one thing I'm seeing here, and this is the reason... This is another reason why I like using the single storehouse. Oh, crap, I forgot something. One of the reasons I like using a single storehouse here is when goods start piling up here, that means both of our peddlers are full of that thing. We're piling up with food, so we're making more food than we need. We are importing wurst and cheese, so we can probably turn those off and still be in good shape and save us some cash. The other thing I realized is we need another herbalist, because we have you need one herbalist per whole housing block here. We're probably going to get hit with a plague. It's not the end of the world, but it's not something we want. So we need to get that herbalist shop, that second one, down toot sweet. And now at this point, I've been putting off getting another woodcutter's lodge for way too long. So another woodcutter's lodge it shall be. And we can probably turn off... Actually, you know what? I'm gonna keep the extra logs on there. We'll let you gather stone and logs if necessary. I'm not gonna tell you to gather them. I don't want you to steal them out of my other production chains. But if there's excess logs, put them there. And these guys will just sit here and continue murdering turd monsters. And all of our... all of our grapes here will be all set and ready to go and ready to plant. Wabam! Interesting that we're lacking leather armor. Why are we lacking leather armor? What's happening to all of our leather? Oh, all right, you're making it. All right, good. I was worried about that. I was like, am I accidentally selling it? Yes, I know. We have research available. We'll make use of it. Because until you spend your research, or your magical research, or your fame, you have the ability to use it however you want. So if you hold on to it, you can apply it and make it useful when you need it the most. And it gives you the flexibility to choose one thing over another.
I'm here, my lord.
Oh, did I tell you to not... Yeah, we don't need you to plant mushrooms, dude. You just need to plant trees. Alright, we have another archer here. Excellent. Yep, so here... They're all... They can just tank and spank these guys all day. Even though they're ranged units and they normally would like to have a melee unit to tank, for these little sewer turd monsters, they're fine. All right, good. We are getting our wood in here. And it's being taken away, so eventually we'll have some excess lumber built up right here. We still have all this excess grain. I might go a little extra with the food here and start selling food. That might not be a bad idea. How are we on workers? Unemployment is low, so... And we still have a whole other clothing... We have a bunch of other clothing shops to build. So that might not be the best of ideas. Alright, let's see here. Alright, we're still building up a lot of food, so I think we need to start selling some of it. Someone's buying wurst, so we can sell that. Sheepberg wants wurst. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to tell my guys, my peddler's tents, not to accept wurst, because we've got eggs and we've got bread. Which means all of our wurst can go for sale and we still should have enough food. I mean, it won't get rid of the wurst that they have right now, but any future wurst that gets deposited here will go actually right to the trade depot here. And so we can use that to get in some more cash. All right, we got our cotton farmers going. Actually, I think what I might do is turn off stone here. Yeah. Alright, we'll let those cook. Now I am gonna get into more of the cotton and the clothing industry here. Alright, we got ourselves a full boat here. A full boat of archers, which is good. Now what we can do here is, because we have all of the infrastructure needed to continue using this, we can get ourselves another squad of archers without having to build any extra infrastructure or employ any other workers here. So I'm going to build ourselves another squad of archers. So they'll slowly start to fill that one up. Yes, it does cost money, but our budget can handle it for the moment. And actually, you know what? I've decided I do want to turn off stone. And we can turn off logs too, since we're making a bit more than we need. Heck, we could even start selling some furniture. Although I'm always hesitant to do that, because as soon as you start selling furniture, people tend to be a little more, like, everyone starts to say, "Oh, where's my furniture? I need more furniture." All right, we are still the, let's see, yep, right at equilibrium. We're gonna have to do some shifts when all of our cotton comes due here. But until this cotton comes ready for harvest, then we'll be in good health. Actually, speaking of cotton ready for harvest, one thing we want to do, and this is one of the downsides to farming your own stuff, is because it all comes in at once, you need a specialty storage yard to handle the incoming goods. So as soon as we see that cotton pop up, we're going to need a storage yard specifically set to hold cotton and nothing but. Now we luck out with the grapes here, because the grapes are their own processors, their own storage yards, their own everything. They are completely self-contained, so we don't need special storage yards for the grapes, and that is quite fortunate for us. Yeah, look at all that trade profit we're making there from the wine, from the. Oh, and actually, now that we're making a whole butt-ton more wine, we can queue up a few more. Ah, see, a couple of them turn themselves off, but that's no matter. We have wine to sell. Heck, we could sell some of our yeah, we have some excess furniture we gotta get rid of. So let's sell that as well. And actually, for the moment, let's turn off some of our more expensive grains, so we're not oversaturating ourselves too much. Because that's getting awfully full. And actually, we can start selling some of our feathers, even though we're using it for bows. People want feathers? They do. Sheepberg wants feathers. You get feathers, Sheepberg. See, now this is kind of how we balance our budget a little bit more carefully. And we're making progress along our way here to our wine selling achievement here. Always good, always good. Is anyone buying eggs or bread? If someone buys bread, we could sell a little of it. If not, that's fine. Does anyone buy eggs? Yes, Lingcom. And they actually pay a pretty hefty price for eggs, given the low nutritional value for eggs. So we will not accept eggs, and just strictly live off of bread here, while our worst and our eggs go to market. There is no sort of health food diversity bonus in this game, so having your people eat a variety of foods is not required. It seems a little counterintuitive, but that's how it works, and I shall take advantage of that. Boy, we're building up some extra medicine too, but I'm not going to be selling that. But yeah, see, all of these goods that we're piling up here are all stuff that we're selling. And once all of these come all due, Oop, research available, eh? Well, lore's getting higher and higher. We could grab that extra thing of mining. That's always a thing. But then there's also... I actually might want to go into archery here to make our archers a little bit more potent. Because we're investing so heavily in them. Archery, although studded armor is pretty good too. Because we're going to, it increases the armor of archers and horsemen. And we're going to be getting into horsemen, which is the southerner's unique unit here. So you know what? Let's get studded armor. Make them a little bit tougher. Because I have a feeling in due time we're going to be faced with some guys. Are you serious? Yes, take them to the stockpiles. Holy crap! Thank you! Eight units of bread! Really? Really? Yeah, we definitely don't need any more food coming in at the moment. We've got tons of it. Now, as our houses grow larger, we are going to start consuming more food, more other stuff, so I am not begrudging this. And we got our archers going here. We can pick up this bag here. Not enough medicine. Ah, crap. Who are the sickos? Yes, we'll take the two cheese. You can eat the cheese. Ah, bugger. And here I thought we were doing pretty good with the medicine. Well, we're going to lose some folks. And that's not really great timing here. Oh, and we got our cotton harvest coming in. Which means we need to get into a couple. We need to rebalance our economy. This is a really bad time for the freaking plague. Oh, wait, no, we got unemployment. Never mind. Let's see here. First off, we need the storage yard for our cotton here. Clear all except for cotton. And now what we need to do here is we need two weavers. Each of these cotton farms can supply clothing to one of these, but we need two weavers to process all the raw cotton into textiles. So two weavers, and then two clothers shops, which actually I'll place down here because it's closer to this thing. So two clothiers shops to actually physically make the clothes. I probably should have put that over here, but eh. Whatevs. Alright, that's enough sickness, please. Apothecary? Medicine zero? Yeah, that was that lapse of medicine that I had realized a little bit too late. You guys can go back to your den here. Have you on standby in case something else fun pops up. Yes, I know, not enough workers. Alright, so in order to deal with this, we are going to temporarily suspend our military production. Just for the moment. Because we want to make sure we have enough of everything else. Once these people, move back in after the plague goes away, we'll be able to recover our population and therefore our workers. Yeah, like I said, really bad timing there on the plague. But that was my fault for not keeping up with the medicine and lapsing on building that second herbalist's tent. Although they should have plenty because there's medicine sitting in right here. What gives, apothecary? I mean, you guys are getting medicine, right? Yeah, we see we're not getting full harvesters here. In fact, what I should do here is let's do high priority for farming, because we want to make sure that that is getting what it's getting. Yeah, that makes the most sense. Alright, enough with the puking. Enough with the sickness. I am not down with the sickness. Yeah, look at all that wine for sale. And look at all this bread we've got built up. This is madness. Our bread makers are certainly productive, if anything. Alright, yeah, and we're building up our supply here, but you kind of need to. Oop, and you guys got our very first shipment of clothing, so while the rest of you are dying, you guys are going to start leveling up. Eventually, the plague will go away on its own. And we'll get more immigrants to counteract the loss of population here. And then once these things de-stinkify themselves, they'll go back to growing as well. Again, temporary setback. But we'll get our population back. This is a much-needed influx and growth here. Now, the next level of... the next level here... so they had 5 to 6. I think 6 to 7 is another... is another how nice is the area growth. So we're gonna get a double-double out of this. Yeah, because you guys are level 5, you've grown to level 6, but you'll evolve again, so it's based on the environment. So we get 2 levels for 1 good. I'd say that's a pretty efficient trade right there, and it'll certainly give us the population we need. And we've got more than enough food to supply everything, and more than enough alcohol to supply everything. We might need to stop selling our furniture, because we're going to be getting higher demands of furniture here. Alright, once we get ourselves back over 1,000, I think we'll be in good shape. Yeah, so the next blocking good here is going to be boots, which we'll be getting into probably in our next episode. But here, I just need to make sure our population will be ready to recover them. So yeah, extra room for 418. We have a lot of people that need to be coming to town. And finally, our sickos stopped with their whole dying thing. Whoa, oh my god, yeah, Dunley loves us. 16 planks? Holy crap! Hold on there, partner! 16 planks! I will not turn down 16 planks. You, my friend, are going to accept planks. And you, my friend, I'm going to stop buying planks from you for a little while, because you just gave me a whole crap ton of them. I mean, I know that's probably exactly what you didn't want to happen, but guess what? It's happening. Because you're gifting me 16 planks. Guys are getting pretty good shots here with the goblins. Alright, so we're going to get a whole metric F-ton of people coming in here. 16 loads of cotton? We're going to have to import some stuff to make up for this, but I don't want to turn down. We'll dispatch them right away. Yeah, so we're going to need to do some importing to help our clothing. By importing cotton. We'll import the cotton that we gave away so that our weavers do not run dwy. Yes, we don't want them to run dwy. That would be terrible. Yeah, you guys got to start growing up here and start eating into this bread a little bit more before it completely takes over my thing here. Because that's one thing you do not want to happen, is have something be completely choked out. See, we've got some clothes going here. You guys want your clothes more. I don't blame you, buddy. We're working on it. Alright, how are we doing? Yes, accept. So, yeah. We don't need to buy any more of those. We're good. Alright, folks. So, in our next episode, how are we doing with people? Unemployment. Alright, we can turn both of these back on. Yeah, no eating civilians, Mr. Turd Monsters. So in our next episode, we will be expanding out, getting ourselves some boots, and also expanding our military might. So if you like this episode and you want to see more like it, go ahead and hit that like button, hit that subscribe button, and leave me a comment. Good, bad, or indifferent, your feedback is always welcome. So until next time, this has been Penstar signing out. See ya.